See, part of the problem is we didn't have a place to hold these folks. And so now I'm working with Congress to increase the number of detention facilities along our borders to make sure that when we catch somebody from a place other than Mexico, there's a place to hold them. And our mission is to end catch and release once and for all on the southern border of the United States, and we intend to do just that.
I'm not sure that a lot of folks here in town understood what it really entailed.
Free the children now!
It's hard to imagine what the government was thinking when they contracted with an adult correction company to run a facility for children.
If you enter the United States illegally, you are somewhat of a criminal.
Me decía, ¿por qué Diosito no nos quiere a nosotros? Si Diosito tiene poder, decía, ¿por qué no viene y nos saca de aquí?
Do we want to be a country that has figured out how to detain families?
We had three things in mind when we made the film. The first was to explore this sort of narrow issue of family detention and whether that's really something that we as a country need to be involved in. Secondly, we really wanted to explore the power of community activism and the limitations of community activism. And thirdly, we wanted to make a point about the importance of transparency and oversight when the government is running facilities like this. This facility was open for 6 months before any outside party. Michelle was the first NGO that was allowed inside the facility. And I'm convinced now that had the activists not become involved in this situation, the conditions that were occurring in Hutto would still be the same, and kids would still be kept in these former prison cells in uniforms and with an hour of education a day. And so, you know, that's a powerful story, and I think Americans need to understand that regardless of where they fall on the immigration issue.
It was quite shocking for me. I've been to a lot of detention facilities and jails and prisons as part of my work, and seeing children that were locked up in what really still looked very much like a prison and who knew and felt as though they were locked up in a prison was pretty shocking, and I think really got to you in your gut. For me, that it was kind of an overwhelming feeling, actually. One of the things that really struck us during the visit was that while we were on our tour, a child slipped a note into the hands of the woman that was with me on the tour, and she kind of opened it later on, and the note said, "Help us, ask us questions." And that, I think, really also threw us off, that a child would be handing us a note in a facility in the United States. Something of that nature was pretty surprising.
It was important for us to sort of reduce the impact of the political rhetoric down to its practical effects. And we were quite careful to portray the context of Hutto in the film, which is that you know, President Obama is purportedly about to introduce immigration reform that closely mirrors the immigration reform that George Bush introduced in 2005 and 2006. And the reason that Hutto came into being was the uproar that rose both on the right and on the left about that immigration reform, and the Bush administration decided to enforce before reforming, and Hutto was the logical outcome of that. You know, whether you agree with it or disagree with it, that's what happened. And I think it's important for people to understand that this political rhetoric has real-life consequences for people.
It is a kind of a good American story, in a sense, if you want to look at it positively, in that you know, there was an action by the government that was uncovered. Unfortunately, it wasn't transparent from the beginning, but it was uncovered. There was action on the part of the public and the media, and there was a response. You know, the fact that it had to go through a lawsuit and to that extent to get there is unfortunate. But in a sense, some of the issues raised have been addressed. And that, I think, you know, that's great that that can happen in this country.